spyware and adware, causing problems for many home and office computers. The software installs itself on a computer via the web. Then once inside, and it doesn't tell you it's doing it, by the way, and when once inside, it allows outside users to get your personal information. Most forms are benign, but it can be frustrating. It can slow your computer down, and in some cases, it can be very serious. How can you tell your computer's been hijacked? Can you prevent it? Joining us to answer these questions and more is Kelly Morrison. Kelly, first of all, the spyware, it just kind of sneaks onto your computer in most cases, right?
That's right.
And I'm sorry, go ahead.
Sorry, go ahead.
It sneaks on. You can download a program. One, for example, I know quite well from having children is Kazaa, the music downloading thing. That is loaded with pretty pernicious stuff. How do you keep it off your computer?
Well, I think the easiest way to keep it off your computer is to prevent it from getting on in the first place, and being very careful about what you download.
Are there any programs out there that will tell me ahead of time you are downloading something that's loaded with spyware?
Yes, actually, there are a number of programs, and a lot of them are free or very inexpensive, that warn you about any sort of unusual download that might be happening and let you know before something installs on your computer.
Once it's there, what can I do?
Well, there are a couple programs, among them AdAware and SpyBot Search and Destroy, that are completely free that will clean your computer of any AdAware and spyware.
Are they... I think I've got SpyBot Search and Destroy on my computer. Now, obviously, it's good for whatever spyware existed at the time they created SpyBot, but does it stay current?
Yes, actually, both of these applications are constantly updating their definitions file, which is definitions of new adware and spyware that might creep into your computer.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm fairly sure that once I use SpyBot, it's not just a one-time thing. I've got to do it repeatedly, do I not? I guess I should have some kind of maintenance schedule.
I definitely recommend having a maintenance schedule. I usually run it about once a week.
And that I often, once a week?
Yes, and I often, well, I download a lot as part of what I do, so I generally have to be extra careful, but I download it every time I download an application just to make sure that, my computer remains spyware-free.
Kelly, this is David Beard. I've experienced issues where my computer slowed down dramatically, but explain to me what are some of the more vicious uses of spyware information.
Sure. Well, at its most innocuous, it'll just serve you pop-up ads, contextual pop-up ads. You might go to Amazon.com and it'll pop up, you know, a competing service or product. That's a pretty simple form of adware, spyware. But there are also applications called keyloggers, dialers, and they will actually track what you're typing in, including credit card information or, you know, all sorts of personal information. And they can actually send that to a remote server. And that's really the biggest danger, aside from really wrecking your PC, is it can really contribute to identity theft.
Why isn't this illegal?
Well,
is there a lack of awareness among our elected leaders that this is going on, or what? I mean, we shouldn't have to be putting up with this.
Some of it is illegal. Some of this behavior, I mean, obviously, it's not legal to, you know, grab your personal information and steal your identity. But there is some legislation in Congress right now that seeks to prevent spyware, specifically undisclosed spyware, from getting onto people's computers.
Is there any good thing that spyware does? Is there a reason I might want to keep it?
Well, some software that's free, and Kazaa is a pretty good example, they include spyware so they can have some way to make money. So if you don't mind pop-up ads, proliferating on your machine, it's maybe not a bad trade-off to get a free application that has adware bundled along with it. It's just very important to read, you know, the end user license agreement when you're downloading any kind of software, because, you know, more reputable software companies will actually tell you what they're installing along with the application, and often, ideally, give you the option of not installing any extra adware applications.
Let's go back to square one. What is the difference between spyware and adware?
Well, spyware is a pretty broad term that describes any application that tracks your whereabouts on the web or mm-hmm. collects your personal information. Adware is usually used to describe the most benign form of that, which is, you know, really simple spyware that just, you know, tracks your whereabouts on the web, and that's it. And it may just pop up ads, and that's pretty much all it does. It just serves advertisements. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't collect your information for any nefarious purposes.
Now, do either of these allow a remote user, to literally hijack my computer, use its processing power for something for its own purpose?
It's certainly within the realm of possibility. The kind of spyware that we've seen more often is the kind that actually collects your information and, you know, actually sends it to a remote location.
All right. Kelly, thanks a lot. Appreciate your helping us out.
All right. Thanks for having me.